हेलो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू आर सेफ एट योर प्लेसेस, स्टे होम स्टे सेफ। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन डायग्राम, और सॉरी स्ट्रेस एंड नंबर ऑफ साइकिल डायग्राम, विच इज कॉल्ड एज SN कर्व, इज अ ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेस एम्पलीट्यूड वर्सेज द नंबर ऑफ स्ट्रेस साइकिल्स बिफोर द फटीक फेलियर ऑन लॉग लॉग ग्राफ पेपर। एज यू कैन सी, दिस इज ऑल्सो SN डायग्राम, इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ओलर डायग्राम, नोटेड विच इज अ जर्मन इंजीनियर हु पब्लिश his fatigue research in 1870, so that's why it is also named as Ohler diagram. So SN curve for the steel, as you can see in the picture, these are the fatigue points and these are the endurance limit stress, which is at 6 or log 10 SE, which is endurance limit, SF is your amplitude or maximum stress of this particular material. Okay, so these are the fatigue point, before means these are the failure point, means if a point of any material is lies above to this, then it is going to fail. Okay, and this is the six, at six this is SE, so note this point, that log 10 6 at log 10 6 this is will become log 10 SE. Okay, so whenever you are doing the calculation, you can also keep in consideration of this SN curve of different kinds of materials. So there are few low cyclic and high cyclic fatigue, that if you will see that any fatigue failure where number of stress cycles are less than 1000, that is called as low cycle fatigue. Okay, if any fatigue failure where number of cycles are more than 1000, okay, then it is called as high cycle fatigue. Okay, now this is the low cycle or high cycle fatigue. Okay, these are the points for low cycle fatigue. As you can see here, that at a point 3 means log 10 3, this is becomes as log 10 SU, which is ultimate strength of any material, and at a 0.6 we have already discussed that it is your endurance limit or log 10 SE. Now let's discuss about notch sensitivity. Basically, notch sensitivity, before studying notch sensitivity, we have to understand what is stress concentration factor. Okay, basically stress concentration factor is the endurance limit of the notch free specimen as well as divided by endurance limit of notched specimen. If you will take the ratio of these two factors, then you will get the value of KF, which is also called as theoretical stress concentration factor. So before calculation of any notch sensitivity factors, you have to calculate this stress concentration factor here. And notch sensitivity is defined as susceptibility of material to succumb to the damaging effect of stress raising notches. Basically means it is prone to damage the material when there are some notches in the material. So that propensity, or I will say sensitivity of that particular material, is called as notch sensitivity. And this notch sensitivity factor Q is defined as increase of actual stress over nominal stress divided by increase of theoretical stress over nominal stress. So in this way you can also calculate the value of Q. If we will go and calculate this particular value, then it will become as Q is equals to KF minus 1 divided by KT minus 1, where your KF is your actual stress. Okay, then actual stress factor, or you can say this particular theoretical stress concentration factor, while KT for the theoretical concern they have kept here KT. Okay, now this equation will become as KF is equals to 1 plus Q KT minus 1. So note this equation in mind, this bit will help you to solve the numericals related to this particular topic. So if you know the value of Q, you can calculate KF. If you know the value of KF and KT, then you can calculate the value of Q. When material has no sensitivity to the notches, that means Q equals to 0 and KF is equals to 1. When material is fully sensitive to the notches, means Q equals to 1, on that point KF is equals to KT. Got it? So in this way you can calculate. Now we came to the point where you have to calculate the endurance limit approximate estimation, which is very essential for the calculation of any further topics like endurance limit approximate estimation. Okay, and for this particular calculation of the notch sensitivity, you may also have such diagrams or such graph papers whenever you are having the exams. Notch sensitivity charts for the reverse torsional shear stresses. So if you know the notch radius, then you can calculate the notch sensitivity factor on the basis of BHN number. If you know the BHN number and notch radius, then you can calculate the notch sensitivity factor. So this is also very essential for the calculation of your notch sensitivity factor. So stay tuned with these topics, okay, as well as the Engineering College Banswara YouTube channel for more such updates. So we will discuss about this endurance limit approximate estimation in upcoming sessions, as well as we will try to cover few last year exam paper numericals on this particular topic, which is on the fatigue fluctuating limit calculations. So thank you so much.